Back in the early 1900s, radiation wasn't the deadly energy we fear today. In fact, radiation was all the rage at wellness resorts, as it was considered to be a natural healing power. Common ails like tuberculosis, cholera, syphilis, and of course cancer could all be seemingly cured with just a few visits to an irradiated spring. But why stop there? You never know when you might get sick, so why not just take a few doses of radium every day? What's the worst that could happen? As a result, a market of products sprung up, from radiation supplements to radium-infused water. One of the most beneficial products you could buy was a radioactive water crock. The inside of the jug was covered with radioactive ore, which would infuse water with radiation. As I'm sure everyone knows, your thirst is never quite quenched without a dose of uranium. But that's not all. You could also buy radioactive tablets, bread, bags, soaps, pillows, jockstraps for the sporting gentleman, contraceptives for the sexually active, makeup, lotions, greeting cards, and even portable air purifiers called nose cups, all of which came with some form of radioactive material. But why buy radioactive products when you could just buy the radium ore? That's right, for just a few of your hard-earned dollars, you can be the proud owner of a box of one-of-a-kind uranium salts for all your radioactive needs. Simply open the box and douse yourself with two, yes, two microcuries a day, and you'll be cured of what ails you in no time. Side effects may include nothing, because it's healthy. Of course, it wasn't long before the amount of radiation poisoning cases started to pile up. Evan Byers, a golfing champion, proclaimed that these reports were false and that he drank 3 bottles of radioactive water a day. He died in 1932 of a radiation-induced sickness which completely rotted his jaw and half his face. Not long after that, the story of the Radium Girls started to circulate. These women painted watch faces with radium and were known to lick the brushes they used. Why use radium for watch faces? Well, because it gave a lovely glow-in-the-dark effect. With the testing of nuclear weapons in the early 1950s, the writing on the wall was clear. Radiation was bad. Very bad. And not long after, Hollywood started cranking out horror films of monsters created by radiation. But harmful effects aside, we still use radiation today because in small doses it can be very beneficial for treating diseases like cancer, although for personal use, the business of making radioactive products has long since decayed. Hey guys, sorry about the pun at the end there, I honestly couldn't resist. If you like what you saw, give the video a like or tap the subscribe button to see more. And if you're looking for something else interesting to watch, check out my video on Banana Dine. The link is on screen now. And as always, thanks for watching.